So, hello everyone. My name is Nikhila Daruri from St. Martin's Engineering College, working as a faculty in SNS department. In today's session, we will discuss about what is business economics. So, especially in this session, we will see what is the definition of business economics and the objectives of business economics. And characteristics of business economics and multidisciplinary nature of business economics. So we will see one by one. First we will cover what is the definition of business economics. So in order to understand what is business economics, we need to first understand what is economic means. So in order to understand business economics, first we will see what is economics. So, first of all, economics is derived from a Greek word called oikonomia, which means, oikonomia means managing household affairs. So, from this, we can derive a definition, which means, if a person earning a particular salary, he may have limited resources, but he and his family may have unlimited wants. So, economics says that how a person allocates his limited resources in order to achieve and fulfill his and his family unlimited wants. So, we have seen what is economics in an action. So, first we just discuss about the father of business economics, who is Adam Smith. Adam Smith, in his book, he has written a book called Wealth of the Nation, has given a definition for economics. So, to put it in a nutshell, we can say that economics is how a government or a firm or an individual allocates his or her resources in order to fulfill his or her unlimited wants. So, we have seen the definition of economics. Now, we move on to the parts of economics, or you can say types, microeconomics and macroeconomics. So, microeconomics deals with individuals, whereas macroeconomics deals with aggregates. So, first we will see what is microeconomics. Microeconomics deals with individuals, as we have seen earlier. So, these individuals may be a firm or a person. May be a household. You can say house. So, here when we say individual, first we will take a firm. Then, microeconomics deals with firm's demand. Firm product and firms may be a marginal cost, etc. So we have seen what is microeconomics. Now let's move on to what is macroeconomics. Macro, the name itself says, it looks at total picture, that means aggregate. So, we can say that macroeconomic deals with the country's inflation rate, a country's GDP, or maybe a country's national income, GNP, etc. So, now we have discussed what is economics, what is microeconomics and what is macroeconomics. Let's move on to what is business economics. So, business economics. As we have discussed, business economics is derived from economics, which talks about a particular business and discuss it about demand, supply, etc. So we have limited resources in many sectors of a business. So we use business economics in order to answer those questions to how to allocate its resources. We have limited resources maybe in a production, maybe in human resource, maybe in a supply also. So here we use business economics principles in order to allocate these resources effectively. So we have seen what is business economics means. Now move on to the objectives of business economics. So objectives would be profit maximization and applying economic theories in business and making a better decisions. So what are the objectives? Profit maximization, applying economics in business and making a better decisions. So now we see what is the characteristics of economics. So when we call characteristics, it explains the nature of the business economics. The first nature would be applied in nature. So applied in nature means business economics applies economics theories into the business. So we said it to be a applied in nature. Then the second feature would be micro in nature. So here micro in nature means business economics always deals with a particular firm. It deals with a particular firm production functions, particular firm's demand and supply. So we can say that business economics is micro in nature. Then here comes next one, which is normative nature. So normative nature is nothing but business economics always gives laws and rules for the business, but the businesses which are running may use these laws in their own perspective. That means they can use these business laws as they want. So we call it to be pragmatic in nature. What is pragmatic in nature? Even though business economics gives laws and rules, the businesses will use these laws and according to their usage. So we have completed pragmatic in nature. Let's take an example for normative in nature so that you can understand it very easily. Let's take a demand law of demand. So we know that law of demand says that price increases, demand decreases. And the price decreases, demand will automatically increase. This law is fixed, but this law can be used by firms differently because every firm has different product, different consumer base and different market to deal with. And maybe sometimes different price. So we can say that business economics is normative in nature. So we have completed normative nature. Then we move on to the important feature, which is macro in nature, which we call as macro analysis. So as we discussed earlier, business economics being a micro in nature, it also deals with macro analysis. That means the business economist who is working in our organization has to see the surroundings, that means external environment. Which includes political environment, economic factors, social factors, technological factors, legal factors, and ecological factors. By seeing and by analyzing all these factors, then only a business economist can take a better decision. We combinedly call it to be a pestle analysis. That means, being a micro in nature, business economics always analyzes the external environment in order to make better decisions. So, now we move on to the important characteristic, which is multidisciplinary nature. So, multidisciplinary in nature is nothing but linkage with other subjects. As we have discussed, business economics always has a linkage with economics. Along with that, it may have and it has different subjects linking with it. So first we will see the basic one, which is economics and business economics. So we have seen that in previously also, business economics always applies economics principles into the business. So we can say that business economics is greatly linked with economics. So it uses theories like demand, supply, and it also takes the external environment into consideration, like inflations of particular countries, deflations, and then it would be national income, GDP, etc. So, we have discussed that economics is greatly related with business economics, or we can say that business economics is dependent on economics. So, now we will see economics, that is business economics and mathematics. So, when we say business economics and mathematics, a business economist has to forecast demand and supply by using mathematical functions. The business economist always uses the logs, that is logarithms, and also uses the linear programming. Which is an advanced model in mathematics. The business economics also uses the symbols of maths. So, the most used symbol we can say, for example, in elasticity of demand, we use elasticity of demand is equal to infinity, equals to 1, equals to 0, like that. So, we are using the symbols of mathematics in economics. So we have done with the two linkage subjects, that is business economics with economics and mathematics. Now we move on to the business economics and statistics. So a business economist always uses the statistical formulas in order to forecast a demand, forecast a price. So, he always uses forecasting techniques of It means some statistics. So we can say that statistics or business economics has a great relationship with statistics. Also, we have other subjects like decision science, psychology, which are always linked with economics and business economics. So, what we have discussed today, we have seen what is economics, what are the parts of economics, that is micro and macro. Then we have moved to what is business economics, what is the objective of business economics, characteristics of business economics, and last but not least, multidisciplinary nature of business economics. Thank you.